The plant pictured here is Cephalanthus occidentalis, the buttonbush. This picture shows the general form of the plant. It's a large, rounded shrub with a fairly open habit. Typically, it gets somewhere around 6 to 12 feet tall and about equally as wide. Here you can see the bark of the shrub. It's not a particularly distinguishing ID feature, but this is what it looks like. And here you can see the stem and leaf arrangement. Buttonbush usually has either an opposite leaf arrangement, as pictured here, or a whorled leaf arrangement with three or more leaves per node, as shown here. In addition, if you look closely at the twigs of buttonbush, you'll see prominent raised lenticels along the stem, as you can see in the picture here. Cephalanthus occidentalis is a deciduous shrub, and here's what the leaves typically look like. They're usually elliptic in shape, with entire margins and an acute apex. However, they are somewhat variable in their shape and apices. The most distinguishing feature of the buttonbush, of course, is the inflorescences. And in the background of this picture, you can see one that hasn't yet opened. So it's just a green globular head. And in the foreground, you see the white flowers once they have opened. The stamens are what we would call exserted stamens because they stick out far past the rest of the flower. And again, these many flowers are arranged on a head, so that whole ball is one inflorescence. The buttonbush blooms in summer. After it flowers, it begins to form a seed head. So it's a globular cluster of nutlets, as you see beginning to form here. It will turn a reddish color when mature, and it persists for most of the rest of the year until the plant blooms again. So with the inflorescences present in some form for most of the year, that helps make buttonbush a little bit more easy to identify.